two men there. Not enough.
It's very good from Morgan. High back with chopping down on the ball, but getting such power and pace onto the ball as well. Very good. And it's forced the change from Ponting that... Second man who is behind square on the offside has gone to mid-wicket, so he's going to bowl a much tighter line now. Putting away behind square. Really excellent example of a left-hander staying with the ball rather than falling away.
Caught and bowled chance. Gets past hopes, goes for four.
Hits the ball very hard. We've already seen that once in this over with that back cut that went for four. This is a very strong shot again. I think the bowler got anything on it because Morgan hit it so hard it was past him in a flash.
Chipped in the air and it's chipped into a vacant space. Three fielders on the leg side and that goes over wide mid-on.
Yeah, made to look very, very easy. And to me, Morgan is very much the key to the rest of this chase for England. If he carries on playing like this, picking up boundaries when he needs it, that's the sort of thing that will get England home.
Ball that's dropped in short and he finds the gap here, yes! 50 partnership between Morgan and Wright.
This is where Morgan can be so good, isn't it? Because he was so quick onto this. It was a little bit short from Horrocks, not horribly short. But he moves his feet well and moves his hands even better.
Oh, that's different again. Clattered away. The crowd loved that shot. It's his own. 30 overs have been bowled, 155 for four. Morgan again, he will find the boundary here. He seizes onto that, as you say, quick hands.
Yeah, it's a bit different up against Shane Watson, who's low 80s compared to the Ryan Harris deliveries of late 80s, early 90s. But once he sees it, it's a combination of forearm and wrist, really, that's so quick.
Extra cover this time. This is a strong shot, powerful shot. Finds the boundary again, 10 from the over.
Yeah, Watson tried to take pace off it, tried to roll his fingers across the ball. Nothing really happened. Still a little bit too full. It's a great shot because, again, absolutely no real effort into it. Minimal follow through with great timing.
50, Eoin Morgan, 50 from 45 deliveries, 7 fours.
Once again, the expression hardly changes. There's an acknowledgement of the applause from the dressing room, from the rest of this crowd here. They've enjoyed it, quite rightly so. And Eoin Morgan now has put England into what should be a very comfortable position, but incumbent upon him now.
Oh, what a shot. What a glorious shot through extra cover. The ball of full length, 89 miles an hour. Well, he's on top form here.
Good balance, really good balance, and then just a little bit of a jog down the pitch, but I think he knew. Oh, and he goes over mid-off. Has he got it all the way? Just short. Excellent shot, though, four more.
It's a length ball outside off stump. You know, Morgan has shown that he loves getting those arms free. Is it a slower ball? It's across the seam, but it doesn't matter when it goes out in the middle of the bat. Fantastic shot.
Brings the 200 up for England.
Short one in there. Just wide of third man. Another boundary. I thought for a second it was straight to third man.
That's it. I think you weren't the only one. Played it well. Short board. He's gone after it. Very wristy. For a moment he'd have been worried. It's deliberate. It's quite deliberate. He's gone there. Quite out the middle of the bat. Low, but four more. That's a great shot. Past the outside edge, time after time. In the over three or four times, and then what happens? Four from the last ball of the over. 225 for five. Got this in the gap, will it go all the way? It will. Great placement.
Yeah, he knows exactly where the fielders are. His placement is just superb. It really is. Again, Horace slowing it up as much as he can, but picked up the length pretty well. Got himself in a fabulous position. That's excellent footwork.
That's gone very fine. I think it will go all the way as well. England really racing away with this now.
Well, unbelievable from Eoin Morgan. Everything he does seems to have boundary written all over it. Even a little tickle down the leg side. What a few months he's having.
That's gone all the way again. He's looking good.
Ponting just lies in the dirt. Can't do anything about it. One of the best fielders in the world. Just a short arm jab, really. Doesn't try and hit it too hard. His balance is superb.
Harris round the wicket. Not quite, but he gets it to the boundary. He'll have to strike another blow.
That's exactly what he was thinking. If it's in the slot, I'm going to go for my favourite area. He has a lot of favourite areas, but off the seamer, it's over mid-wicket. Leg out the way, doesn't get it all. Gets enough to move him to 98.
There he goes. That's the winning shot, and also the stroke that brings up three figures for Eoin Morgan. What a knock.
Cool and calm until he hit that last one. I think he realises he's got 100 this time round. Wins the game, no better feeling. The England dressing room celebrate. The man in the middle has delivered. Might not got the volume of runs in Test match cricket, the two Test matches against Bangladesh, but back in one day cricket, back with 100. Eoin Morgan really is a superstar.
The shot that did it, straight back down the ground, and he knew it immediately, so did they. Victory, yes, but also three figures for the man who did the job for England. This one-day series this time around against Australia certainly started a lot different from the last one last summer. England convincing victories in this, the first of them.
300s now for Morgan, one for Ireland, two for England. World Cup winner, first game against Australia winner, and England continue their good run. That's the most important thing. All the work they've done this winter in one day cricket continues with a mighty impressive win against Australia.